Hi guys, I'm Katie Wayne and this is Animalist News. Being monogamous isn't the social norm in the animal kingdom. In fact, only 6% of primate species mate for life. Gibbons form incredibly strong bonds with their partners and are the closest relatives to humans that are monogamous. These cuties can often be seen grooming and doing social activities together while raising a family. But even gibbons aren't perfect. New studies have shown that some couples will divorce or cheat on each other. Maybe gibbons could learn something from prairie voles. These rodents share equal roles in the relationship. When paired, females and males will both gather food, groom each other, and share parental duties. Through the good times and the bad, prairie voles tend to spend their entire but very short lives together. When scientists tempted males with sexy new female voles, less than 10% cheated on their partner. Why are scientists doing this? I don't know, but it seems so wrong. Even when their partner eventually died, less than 20% tried to find a new mate. Oh, you see, that's cute. How could we end this episode without mentioning some of the most notorious lovebirds in the world? There's a reason the image of swans with their necks entangled in a heart shape is a universal symbol of romance, but it may not be as cute as you think. Some scientists believe that swans are monogamous so they don't have to constantly waste time attracting new mates. Plus, many swans have a little something-something on the side. Well, that's a mood killer, but it doesn't mean that they don't care about their partner. When one swan dies, the other may go through a mourning period for up to 3 years. What's the most romantic thing that you've ever done for someone? Be sure to let me know in the comments below. Also, be sure to check out these other videos right here and subscribe right here. I love you all, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Mwah.